Hi, I'm Wade from Thoroughbred Diesel, and today we're going to be showing you S&S Diesel Motorsport's CP4 bypass kit for the 6.7 Powerstrokes. Hello to the good folks out there in TV land. This is S&S Diesel Motorsport's third revision of their CP4 bypass kit for the 6.7 Powerstrokes. Now, a little bit of trickery here in the part numbers. This is call sign Gen 2.1, a la second generation first revision. That's a lot to remember, but just remember, this is the premium CP4 bypass kit out there on the market today. And S&S has spared no expense to perfect this kit. They really haven't. So what we're going to do first off is we're going to give you another highlight of how a CP4 bypass kit works. And then I'm going to talk to you about what this new part number entails and a couple of new part numbers that we've got out in the kit that's going to service the older versions of the S&S Diesel CP4 bypass kit. So first off, quick rundown. What does a CP4 bypass do? So the CP4 injection pump, high pressure injection pump, has been one of the most problematic high pressure injection pumps that we have seen in light duty diesels. So they are known to grenade and have, for lack of a better word, shrapnel pass through the CP4 pump. That shrapnel goes out to your injectors, to your high side fuel lines, contaminates everything. When you have that failure, it is a very, very costly repair for you guys that are outside of warranty. S&S saw that, and because they've got this kit was designed by a couple of fuel system engineers, you have the product that is going to protect you from that type of failure wiping out your entire high side fuel system. So let's talk about what a CP4 bypass does. So I'm going to talk about features of this, but again, just quick rundown of what happens here. So your CP4 has a metering valve that has low side fuel that enters into the CP4 pump, into the belly of the CP4 pump. But the problem with that is that's where the failure is in the belly of the CP4 pump. So then those debris pass through the metering valve and then out to the injectors. So what S&S did is they redirected the low side fuel. And what the new billet block does from S&S Diesel, you remove your metering valve from the CP4, you place this block off in there, then you put the metering valve back in it. Okay, so now you're getting your metering valve, which is sending the fuel out to the injectors and all your high side components, is getting its fuel supply directly from your factory filtration. So it's clean, it's not the contaminated fuel coming from the belly of the pump where the failure originates. This is clean fuel that has already been through the two OE filters that are on the 6.7 Powerstroke trucks. That is ingenious in itself right there. Now, with that, they have also integrated a return fuel filter. So at the origin of the failure, which we talked about, the belly of the pump, the return fuel contains the contaminants. The return fuel passes through this filter and filter head that S&S has designed. Those contaminants are caught here in this filter and then sent back to the tank. So the debris are caught here and then set. The return fuel that goes back to the tank is filtered. Then the fuel coming back in the entire circle of life here goes through two OE filters. So it's triple filtered by the time that it gets back to the CP4 pump. That is a huge thing. It's an ingenious design, so really, really good. Now, this has been a wildly popular product from S&S Diesel. You will know that the previous version, the Gen 2 version, had a plastic filter on it. Okay, the plastic filter was very, very nice, but we were having a lot of supply chain issues. You can't have supply chain issues in a product that is keeping you from having catastrophic failure. S&S saw that, and as frustrating as it was, they went back to the kit and said, what do we do? How do we come up with a new return fuel filter? So in your block for the FCA that is on the pump there, they went back and did a billet aluminum filter head that has actually got their logo etched into it with S&S Diesel. All quick connect fittings on that, full billet, and it works back into the stock location of where your old filter was located. This is going to use a Donaldson filter that is readily available at all of your auto parts stores. You can purchase them from us here at Thoroughbred Diesel. This Donaldson part number is pretty popular as well, so you won't have any problems finding it. You can change that at regular intervals when you change your fuel filter, changing your oil, however you want to do it. It's a lower cost filter as well, so it's cheap. It's cheap insurance. Change the fuel filter on the return side of it. So S&S also does a really, really good job with this kit. They integrated back all of the Ford OE style quick connectors. So you don't have to cut off any ends anywhere. You don't have to go away from any of that. This is going to click on all of the existing portions of where they're going to go on the truck at the high or at the low side fuel filter underneath of the hood. So you don't have to change anything. And in fact, they use the Ford OE style quick connect filters throughout the whole system as well. Now, this supply line, they also made this 25 inches long. And what this does is this is clean fuel supply going to the pump, but it is split. You'll notice the split there. Now you have clean fuel that is actually going back to the belly of the pump too, because the belly of the pump is still going to need fuel supply for lubrication of it. So you're getting clean fuel that is actually going back to the belly of the pump. But they made this line 25 inches. And the reason why they did that is because if you have a catastrophic failure, that is a double super secret squirrel Gen 5 failure, and you have enough debris coming from the belly of the pump to block up the return system and it starts to feed back into your low side supply, they made this 25 inches away from the FCA. You can't get the debris there. It's just a mathematical impossibility, boys. It just ain't gonna happen. All right, so we've talked about what the kit is. We talked about the advancements that they've made and the changes in this newest version of the kit. Pricing at this time is going to stay the same. This kit comes in completely redesigned with a high dollar aluminum part added into this kit, but S&S is keeping the cost the same for you as of the time of this filming. I want to talk about S&S's packaging on the CP4 kit, not to bore you to death with things, but this is another work of art that they've done. First off, I like to give a shout out to them for including instructions inside the kit. The instructions are full color and they're going to walk you through the installation. Anybody is going to be able to do this, okay? The kit for you guys that own shops, I would suggest for you to have three or four of these on the shelf. This is perfect upsells for our 6.7 customers. There's more 6.7 Powerstrokes on the road out there than any place. The display of the kit, of the packaging of the kit, you can just open up the box and put it on your counter. Your customers will see it when they walk in and they're going to be like, ooh, I see all the blingy, shiny stuff. I need to put that on my truck. So even their packaging, they've done a very good job of designing and engineering this to be able to present this to your customers, to be able to say, hey, I like that. I like the way that looks. That's smart. Give me one. So you shops, purchase two or three of these and put them on your counters for display. Now let's talk about a couple of different things that we've got going on inside of part numbers with this. Now, inside of this family, there's going to be three part numbers. First off, obviously the Gen 2.1 CP4 bypass kit, which covers model years 2011 to current at the time of this filming. You're talking about the 2021-22 trucks. Good to go on there. One part number, that's another change. It was two, now it's one. All right, now we're going to have the next part number in that family is going to be just for the filter head assembly. Now, the part number for just the filter head assembly is going to be the upgrade for you guys that have purchased last year's kit with the plastic filter. You want to convert over to the aluminum base and the new Donaldson filter. We got a part number for you on that. And at the time of this filming, 2022, we have special pricing that S&S is going to hold for you throughout the calendar year on that. So check the website for that. It's very, very good. Now, the third part number is for our Gen 1 customers. Now, Gen 1 customers that bought the S&S CP4 bypass kit, they did not have the return filtration integrated into that kit. Great kit, but we didn't have the return filtration. They have come out with a kit for that that is going to use this aluminum head with the fuel filter, return filter, so now you can put all of that together. You don't have to cut anything. It's all on quick connect, so it's going to work right in for you. So good to go on that. So Gen 1, guys, we've got a new product for you all to add to the effectiveness of the CP4 bypass kit. So, whew, it's a mouthful, a lot to say, and a lot to talk about. A couple of small, subtle changes, big changes to this, but still, this is one of the most impactful parts that we have seen in light-duty diesel in a while. It works. It's a good thing. If you've got a 6.7 power stroke, I definitely suggest that you get one of these on your truck. So, I'm Wade, Thoroughbred Diesel. Big shout out to S&S Diesel Motorsports for supporting us, get us product to show to you guys to be able to present out there to you all. And we're going to be doing an installation video. So the normal stuff, we're going to link you in this video where you can buy the kits, all three of the different part numbers, depending on what you need. We're also going to link you to our installation video for the CP4 bypass kit. It might not be on that today, but it will be within the next week or so. So I'm Wade, Thoroughbred Diesel. Thanks for watching.